Hey guys, my name is Sujarita. This is Film Companion. You are watching not a movie review, and right now I am not going to be reviewing La La Land. भाई ये वाला मुश्किल है. There are movies, there are musicals, and then there is this stuff. That's a movie, a musical, and a work of art that will make you want to laugh, cry, sing, dance, break up, get married, essentially reevaluate your whole entire life. La La Land has wrecked me. This is the story of struggling actress Mia and struggling jazz musician Sebastian. They meet, fall in love, nachna gana, rona dhona, sab. I won't say the story is utterly predictable, because it isn't, but it is very simple, which is what makes this movie so fucking amazing. Despite a very straightforward, to-the-point storyline, La La Land takes you away on such a whirlwind tour of every emotion possible. You know, I think this is one of those movies that anyone can interpret in any way. I believe everyone will take something unique and different back home from it. I don't know, like, you might feel the absolute absence of love in your life, or feel the need to quit your job and just follow your dreams, or might lament the loss of a dear one, or even anger over disrespect shown to your favorite form of art. I was upset because lack of song singing boyfriend.
Or one more dream that I cannot make true.
And lack of Ryan Gosling in my life. One song has Ryan Gosling dancing and singing, no lights are turning on. Yahan kya kya turn on ho gaya, aapko lights ki padi hai. But having said that, La La Land is an Emma Stone show. It's her in one of the earlier scenes in the movie where she's auditioning for a role, having a conversation with someone on the phone. Now, we know she's acting, there's no one on the telephone. But she also knows that we know that she's acting and she has to act like she's acting to talk on the phone. Within 10 seconds, you see her move from making small talk to surprise to sadness to tears to exasperation to complete dejection. 10 seconds. This is how you just, you know, just give into the character. Become her.
Two options. You either follow my rules or follow my rules. Capiche?
Thank you.
I can do it a different way.
No, that's fine. Thank you very much.
The casting is just so perfect. Miles Teller from director Damon Chazelle's Whiplash was supposed to play this part along with Emma Watson. But dates etc. ki wajah se Gosling and Stone were cast. John Legend is in here too, playing a jazz musician who's well jazzed things up a bit. Abhi nahi bataungi, movie dekho, pata chalega. And interestingly, J.K. Simmons plays this bar owner who hates jazz and fires Ryan Gosling for playing his music and not Christmas carols. Whereas in Whiplash, kuch aur hi scene tha. Which is a massive win for director Damon Chazelle. He's taken jazz and made another masterpiece at the age of 31. He's 3 years older than me. What am I doing with my life? Is another thought that might or might not plague you after this movie is over. Mera to full confidence khatam ho chuka hai. The camera actually sets the pace of the film. Swedish cinematographer Linus Sandgren has choreographed each and every shot to an unparalleled level of perfection. Even for noobs like myself, when I see a shot of a man jumping into a pool from a rooftop and I go in the water with him and the music starts again just at that moment of the splash, you're like, oh my god, what a shot! La La Land isn't just a movie, it is cinema. The whole entire experience of how movies are made. Ek to because it is set in behind the scenes Hollywood, but also because it is the perfect amalgam of every sensory need a human being can possibly have. This is the Wizard of Oz, this is I Dream of Jeannie, this is a pastel color palette, this is magic. On a scale of 1 to 10, La La Land is 3 hours at least it took me after the movie to normalize ek to. Be prepared, huh? Ye chalchitra aapko vichalit kar sakta hai. Fun fact, the audition scene I spoke about where Emma Stone is on the phone and laughing, crying, everything at the same time, that actually happened to Ryan Gosling. He was auditioning and someone interrupted to take a phone call to talk about lunch. You don't do that to Ryan Gosling. And you definitely don't do that to me. Click here now, watch other videos. And subscribe to Film Companion for Ryan Gosling.